All right, welcome back to another 5K Tennis Fantasy Team and Cash Giveaway Competition. This is always my favorite time of the year, being Wimbledon, but also too as well playing these two games. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a quick rules video. This video will tell everybody exactly how we play the game and where to put in your picks and so forth. So I'll make it quick as not to take up too much of your time. We will do one of our live shows and talk about Wimbledon here later on this afternoon. All right, so we are going to take the $500 that was not won at Roland Garros and add $100 to it and make the pot for the cash giveaway $600. So the first game I'm going to start with is the $600 cash giveaway. What does it take to potentially win that $600? Only criteria is be subscribed. So if you haven't subscribed, click the subscribe button. It's free. So when Wimbledon begins, or before the tournament begins, in the comment section of this video, you, if you are playing, you will predict the men's finalists and the women's finalists and both winners. So let's say I think Djokovic will meet her catch in the final and Djokovic will win. And let's say I think Iga Swiatek will meet Serena Williams in the final and Serena Williams would win. If those picks happened, then I would win that $600. It's that simple. Now, the picks must be in before the tournament begins. So once the first ball is struck, if you are going to play for that $600, make sure your picks are in before the first ball is struck. Once the first ball is struck, the entries will lock. Now, what happens if there's a tie? If there's a tie, the fantasy team competition, which is the next game I'm going to explain, will break that tie. Now, you do not have to play both games. You can just, hey, put in a finals prediction, and if you win, great. But the problem is if there's a tie and you don't have a fantasy team and someone else does, then that tie won't be able to be broken because you won't have a team. So it's always good to at least pencil with a fantasy team. So the next competition is the fantasy team competition. The top two winners will receive $50 in cash. By the way, the prizes, the $600 in cash for the final predictions, if you guys would rather have apparel, tennis rackets from Diadem Sports, or strings from Y-Tech Strings, two of our sponsors, then you can pick or choose whether you want the cash or whether you want the apparel, strings, tennis rackets, or prizes. If you want a mixture of both, that's fine. We had one gentleman that won at one point in time, and he wanted, you know, a tennis racket and then some of the cash, you know, the difference between it. So you can do that as well. All right. So for the fantasy team competitions, I'm going to give you the rules. If you have any questions, please let us know in comments and we will address those questions relatively quickly. Okay. So the fantasy team competition is played as such. Each competitor, meaning you or I or anybody that's going to play, mm-hmm. must choose a total of 18 players, 9 men and 9 women, okay? Out of those 18 players, let's say now you have two, so you have two separate teams. You have a men's team and a women's team, okay? But you turn them in as one, okay? So on the men's team and women's team, you have 9 players each, so 9 men, 9 women. Out of those 9 men or 9 women, you can only have a maximum of 4 players that are seeded inside the top 20. Now, remember that word seeded. Sometimes a player will be ranked, you know, 21 in the world, but they'll come in seeded, you know, 17th because a top player didn't play. Like Medvedev's not playing because he's Russian. We won't get into that. We'll talk about that on the show this afternoon. Osaka's not playing. So some people will come in seeded a little bit lower. So be careful. You can only have a maximum of 4 players seated inside of the top 20. You can have as many players as you wish seated outside of the top 20. Okay. Each team, each men's team and each women's team must have one qualifier or one wild card. So again, max players 4. Seated inside the top 20. You can have as many as you want seated outside of the top 20, but each men's team and each women's team must have one wild card or a qualifier. And I'll tell you why. By the way, Serena Williams drew a wild card, so I'm assuming most of you would choose Serena as your women's wild card. All right. Players that are seated within the top 20 are only worth 1 point per match win. Okay. Players seeded outside of the top 20 are worth 2 points per match win. Your wild card or qualifier, whichever one you select, is worth 3 points per match win. After the tournament is done, all the points will be added up and there will be two winners crowned. Now, shout out to Thomas Chi in Canada and Gene Swart in South Africa. They've played this game with us for a long time when I was doing it by hand. And they said, hey, let's create a program that will score these for us. So Thomas Chi and Gene Swart did that, and they've been keeping score for the past few majors and have hit it right on the head. And Carl and I pay those two to do that work for us. So Thomas Chi and Gene Swart will keep up with the scoring. It will be it'll be calculated daily, and at the end of each round, at round one completion, we'll do a score update and leaderboard and so forth. When the tournament ends, the top 2 point earners will each receive $50 or that amount in YTEC strings or D&M apparel or whatever, or that much money towards a racket, whatever. Okay. I wrote down two hypothetical teams. Mm-hmm. All right. So if I was playing, granted the draws aren't out, you're going to want to wait till the draws come out for sure. So I wrote down an example team for men and women, and this is just hypothetical. So on my men's team, I selected Novak Djokovic and Sasha Zverev. Those are 2 1-point players per win.
Even though Zverev's not playing.
Yeah, I pencil whipped something. Yes, pencil whipped something. He has head ligament surgery. We know that. I just pencil whipped something. Okay. Then I chose Dimitrov, Khachanov, Isner, Bashvili, Kyrgios, and Querrey, all 2 point players. And then I picked Pospisil, the Canadian, as my 3 point player. And again, I didn't look at anything. You can't. The draws aren't out. If you can't turn anything in until the draws come out. Anyway, that was how my men's team broke down. On the women's team, again, I didn't even look. I just came off the top of my head. On my women's team, I selected Ons Jabeur and Iga Swiatek as my 1 point players. As my 2 point players, I selected Madison Keys, Haddad Maia, Kvitova, Kanepi, Stevens, Andreescu, and then selected Serena Williams as my wild card because, as we know, she drew a wild card. We'll talk about that later on the live show as well. So when you turn these teams in, you're going to put them in the comment section of this video, okay? So that way all the competitors can see what they're going up against, and Thomas Chi and Gene Swart can make sure they log down and enter in your selections. All teams must be submitted on this video in the comment section prior to the first ball being struck. One thing we do have to be careful for is lucky losers. If one of your players that you selected pulls out of the tournament, then you will be stuck with the lucky loser unless Gene Swart or Thomas Chi, myself, or Carla catches it and gets in touch with you and says, hey, you need to switch this player. We try our best to keep up with all that, but sometimes a lot of people play, so sometimes we miss it. So be mindful of that. Put the teams in the best order that you can. In other words, you know, don't put them just in a paragraph and expect, you know, Thomas Chi or myself or Carla or Gene Swart to figure it out. I'll show you. Just kind of put them like this in a list. You'll see on the top I have my 1 point players, and then there's a space, and then I put my 2 point players, and then there's a space, and then I put my 3 point players. And again, we're logging this down and writing a score sheet, so just help us and make it a little bit easier, because sometimes we're writing down a lot or typing down a lot of scores and having to keep up with them. So do it nicely. I mentioned this. Okay, so yeah, any mistakes or any questions, please try your best to contact us about questions. Any mistakes, we will try our best to catch. Can't always promise that we will. So anyway, that is the rules. If you feel like I missed anything, if you feel like I missed some important bit of information, please, by all means, reach out to us in comments. You can catch up with Carl and I both on Facebook two ways, either 5K Tennis on Facebook, or you can go to our personal page, which is Justin, J-U-S-T-I-N, space Carla, C-A-R-L-A, space Davis, D-A-V-I-S. And we'll accept that or the private chat, and we'll discuss about it there. But again, all team selections must be put here, because when the second week comes and there's five people battling it out for the finish, everyone wants to see who everyone else has, okay? Don't forget to subscribe. That's the only qualification. And get ready for a heck of a really, 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 really good tournament. Wimbledon's been my favorite. I do have some mixed emotions about this one because of the country's not being allowed to play, and we'll talk about that more later, all right?
All right.
So that's it. We'll call it out. Peace out. Give me that finish button. All right. Take care. And we will see you in 3 hours for the live show. It might be less once this publishes. All right. Take care. Let's go. Good luck. I play to win. Let's go. And I know Carla does too. Peace.